Everybody say yes. Yes. To VBS.
But we cannot go to church. How can we have VBS this year?
Don't worry. Nothing can stop us from having fun in learning God's word. Not even COVID virus. This year, VBS is coming into your homes. Wow, isn't that awesome? All you have to do is tune to our KKC online video every Sunday for the whole month of November, beginning from today. Not only that, at the end of VBS, we have a surprise for all of you.
What is the surprise?
I will tell you more next week. This year in VBS, we are reminded that Jesus' power will pull us through. And today, we are learning that His power will help us to do hard things, especially during this COVID pandemic period. But before we begin, let us commit our VBS into God's hand and ask Him to bless our time together. Shall we? Children, are you ready? Let's pray. Father God, we want to thank You for Your grace and protection upon all of us. Thank You that we can still worship and we can still have fun learning from You in VBS. Speak to us even in our homes. Help us to be strong. And remember that we can have Your power to do great and challenging things that come our ways. Help us to shine for You wherever we are. May Your name be glorified and magnified during a time like this. In Jesus' name, we submit ourselves and pray. And all God's children say, Amen. So are you ready? If you are ready, come, let the fun begin.
Hi children! Ha! Wow, this year is a very special year. You know why? Because we are doing VBS online. So children, I am very ready for this recording. And are you ready to learn God's words? So get excited. Before that, let me introduce these two young lady and men. I know if you are regular at KKC at home or regular every year VBS, you will know them for the first time up. Okay, let them introduce themselves.
Hi, I'm Tete Ashley.
Hi, I'm Gogo Kevin.
And I'm Auntie Susan. Are you ready to start? We are ready. Let's start.
Trust in You, Jesus. You're all, You're all, You're all that we need. Your power will pull us through. We're trusting in You. We're trusting in You. You give us hope and life that's forever. You make us bold and we stand together. This journey, there's no looking back. With Jesus to lead us, we're on the right track. Oh, 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 oh. Wide open spaces for wide open eyes. We're looking ahead for the next big surprise. Oh, 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 oh. Trusting in You, you give us hope and life that's forever.
wide spaces for wide open eyes. We're looking ahead for the next big surprise. Oh, oh, oh.
We have a buddy that we can learn from. Today, our buddy is Ramsey.
I'm Ramsey, a bighorn sheep. Can you guess why? Okay, that was too easy. Check out these cool, curvy horns God gave me. Ram's horns can weigh up to 30 pounds. That's as much as some of our littlest preschool buddies. Wow! My horns have to be tough, because we male sheep use them to keep other rams out of our territory. People who study rams say we can run into each other at 20 to 40 miles per hour. Bam! You can hear that sound for miles! Me and my herd hang out all over the majestic, massive Rocky Mountains. The Rocky Mountains rock! If you head up to find me, strap on your hiking boots. Sometimes my herd grazes in an alpine meadow. Cause that's where the good stuff is. Wow, good. But the meadow makes us an easy target for predators. So we also like to climb way up those crazy cliffs. We sheep like it steep. Me and my family can hang out on a little teeny tiny ledge that's only a few inches wide. Animals like bears or coyotes can't bother us here. Whew! And check out the view! God made us just right for staying safe in those hard, rocky places. My hooves are split and have a rough skin on the bottom that grips tight to the rugged rocks. Plus, I've got excellent eyesight. No glasses for me. It may sound like climbing these cliffs and balancing on jagged ledges is hard to do, but God has given me everything I need to live here. Find food and my family safe. I've heard that you sometimes have to do hard things too. When there's a bully at school, maybe you feel like you're in a rough, rocky place. You may not be balanced on a cliff ledge like me, but maybe you have to balance homework, chores, sports, music, and friendships. That sounds hard. But did you know you don't face those hard things alone? No way! Jesus is right beside you. Yep, even right now. He gives you His power to climb through those mountains of worry and get through any rough stuff you gotta do. The Bible powers you up with this truth. For I can do everything through Christ who gives me strength. That means you don't have to have your own power to do hard things. Jesus' power helps us do hard things. Trust Jesus.
Ananias! Ananias!
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, I'm here.
Go to a street called Straight. I want you to pray for a blind man in the house of Judas. Put your hands on his eyes.
Lord! No, not me. I can't go. I can't do it, Lord. I'm very frightened. I'm not going to go there, Lord. Please send someone else. I'm not going there, Lord. Please.
Ananias, do you believe in me? I will give you the power.
Yes, Lord. I will go. I hope your power will go with me and give me the courage to do so. Yes, Lord, I obey. I will go, Lord. Hello, children. Auntie Mountain here again. Welcome to our Bible station. Who's the man in the short skirt? God called him Ananias. His name is Ananias. What did God ask him to do? What mission did God ask him to do? Why must he go to the street called Straight? Do you want to find out? Are you eager to know? If so, let us watch a video and find out who this Ananias is and why is God calling him. Come, children, let's watch the video.
Saul's conversion and escape, Acts 9, 1 through 30. After the Jews stoned Stephen, a Pharisee named Saul became very active in persecuting Christians. He went to the believers' homes and had them arrested, imprisoned, beaten, or even killed. Saul terrorized the church. When Christians moved away to other places, Saul was determined to find them and bring them back to Jerusalem for punishment. Saul went to the high priest and asked for letters to show the Jews in the synagogues in Damascus. If he found any Christians there, he would have permission to bring them back. As Saul and his guards traveled the road to Damascus, a bright light suddenly shone on him. It was so bright that Saul could not see and fell down on the ground with his eyes closed. Then he heard a voice call his name, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" "Who are you?" Saul called out. "I am Jesus, the one you are persecuting. It is hard for you to fight against me, isn't it, Saul?" the Lord said. Saul was afraid. "What do you want me to do?" he asked. "Get up and go into the city. Someone will tell you what to do," said Jesus. The men traveling with Saul were shocked. They could hear the voice, but they could not see anyone. When Saul stood up and opened his eyes, he was blind. His men had to lead him by the hand to Damascus. Saul could not see for 3 days. During that time, he did not eat or drink anything. Meanwhile, the Lord spoke to a faithful disciple in the city. Ananias, called Jesus. I am here, Lord, said Ananias. Go to a street called Straight, Jesus instructed. At the house of a man named Judas, ask for Saul of Tarsus. He is praying. He has seen a vision of you putting your hand on him and restoring his sight. Ananias was afraid. He had heard about Saul. Saul has done evil to the believers in Jerusalem, Lord. He has letters from the high priest to arrest the Christians here and take them back. Go to Saul. I have chosen him to be my witness to the Gentiles, kings, and Jews. He will suffer many things for testifying in my name, Jesus said. Ananias obeyed. He found Saul and put his hands on him. Something like scales fell from Saul's eyes, and through the power of the Holy Spirit, he was able to see again. He was then baptized to show that he had trusted in Jesus as his Savior. Saul spent many days talking with the disciples at Damascus and learning about Jesus from them. In the synagogues, Saul boldly preached to the Jews that Jesus is the Son of God. Everyone was amazed at the change in Saul. They had trouble believing that this same man who was killing Christians in Jerusalem was now preaching about Christ in Damascus. The Jewish leaders there decided that Saul was a traitor and should be killed. They watched the gates of the city day and night, planning to grab Saul if he tried to leave the city. Saul found out about the plan and didn't go through the city gate. Instead, the believers put Saul in a large grain basket. Carefully and quietly, they lowered him over the city walls to safety. Saul escaped back to Jerusalem. But because of Saul's reputation for killing Christians, things did not go well there either. When he tried to join the disciples, they were afraid of him and would not believe he was a Christian. God helped a Jewish believer named Barnabas to realize that Saul was a Christian. Barnabas took Saul to the apostles, the church leaders at the time. Barnabas told the apostles how Saul had seen and talked with Jesus on the road to Damascus, and how Paul had preached boldly in the synagogues in Damascus, and how he had to escape by night because the Jews wanted to kill him. Finally, the believers in Jerusalem accepted Saul as a true Christian. Saul spent much time with them preaching and teaching about the Lord. In fact, Saul was so bold in his preaching that he put his life in danger again. He had to leave Jerusalem. The believers took him to Caesarea and sent him by ship to his hometown of Tarsus. If God can save a terrible person like Saul, then he can save anyone. God loves all people and wants all of them to trust in him as their Savior. That is why he gave us the job of telling others about him. Let's be faithful in sharing God's message of salvation.
Children, did you enjoy our video just now? What is the video about? Ah, you are right. In the video, we learned that God called His servant. What is his name? Can you still remember? Yes, it is Ananias. Why is Ananias so special? Why is God calling him? In the story, you have found out that Ananias was sent by God to put his hands on Saul's eyes. What happened to Saul? Ah, you are very right. Saul is such a bad man. Before he came to know the Lord, Saul did a lot of bad things. He persecuted Christians, he put them into prison, he beat them up, stoned them. But in the story, we have watched that God did a miraculous things. With God, all things are possible. From Saul, he became Paul. From a persecutor, Paul became the one who was persecuted. But children, today, the star of our story is not Paul. Who is the star of our story? Ha, you are right. It is Ananias. Children, many of us cannot be Paul because Paul is such a dynamic man. When he was used by God, he did so many things. He went to heal people. For that, he was shipwrecked, he was persecuted, when before that, he was the persecutor. None of us can be like Paul, but children, we can be like Ananias. Why is Auntie Mao Ching saying that? Because Ananias is a simple man. He's a follower of Jesus. You see, children, when we accept Jesus as our personal Lord and Savior, we are His children, we are His followers. And what Ananias did was, he obeyed Jesus. He did what God asked him to do. He went to the town of Damascus. He went to see Saul. And from there, he encouraged Saul, and later Saul became Paul. Jesus gave him the power to do hard things, to overcome, to pull through. Children, we can be like Ananias, simple man. Many of us may think, I'm not significant, I'm not important. But to God, all of us are important. God can use all of us, and He promised to give us the power to do hard things. Children, during this difficult time, with the pandemic COVID-19, you can play a part too. You can share the love of Christ with your friends, with your neighbors, and even your classmates and schoolmates. Show them the love of Jesus. Be like Ananias. I hope you enjoy our story today. Thank you. See you next week.
Hi, children. Wow, it's VBS time. And children, today you are here for the first day.
Hello, hello, hello. Calling all children, come into Imagination Station. Come, 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 come.
Children, come, go and get all your friends and come in to Imagination Station. I know, Imagination Station is the favorite of favorites during VBS. So, did you bring your imagination, children? Okay, let's work up our imagination. Okay, shall we? Rub our head, scratch our head, and get some brain juice out so that we can imagine, we can learn to the fullest, even for this lesson. Are you ready? Okay, let us begin. Oh, I have some potatoes. How many of you love to eat potatoes? Ah, I'm sure you all love potatoes made into mashed potatoes. KFC mashed potatoes. Then, we also got some straw. Straw you can easily find in your house. Potatoes you can easily ask your mommy to buy from the market. Now, what has potato and straw to do with today's lesson? Now, I need a helper. I shall call upon Gogo Andrew to come and help. Come!
Hello, hello.
Hi, Andrew. Today, you like potatoes?
Yes.
Put potatoes aside, okay? Object lesson first.
Alright. Okay.
Okay. I want to give you a challenge.
Alright.
Okay, take a potato.
I like fat potato.
Oh, I like thin potato. Give yourself a straw.
Straw?
Yeah. My challenge to you, Andrew, is to put the potato. Sorry. I forgot to bring my imagination.
Okay.
Put the straw through the potato. Try and see.
Okay.
I know you are very clever one. Yeah, I know that you are very strong one.
Muscles.
Easy or not?
I cannot get it through. It's impossible. How?
I know. Andrew, you have done your best. But your best is still not good enough. Okay, let me show you.
Alright.
Children, do you know, in life, there are many hard things that we face. There are many problems. Especially, even now, with the COVID-19, I'm sure all the children, our KKC children, face a lot of hard things to do. Example, putting on masks. So mafan. Must remember to wear masks. Sometimes auntie also forget to wear masks. Get out of car, come back into the car, wear masks. Hard things, wear masks. Even learning at home, difficult. You cannot go even to go and play with your friends. And sometimes cannot go near our grandparents also because they are old. Alright? And children, we have problems and problems every day. Hard things to do. So children, what can we do? Remember, you are never alone, children. God is near. God will help you. But if we need help from God, we must not treat God like a servant, call on God. We must do our part, you know?
Yes.
What are the things that we must do if we need God's help? We must continue to pray to God. We need to continue to read God's word. We also need to worship God and learn at KKC. And also, you know, do you know, children, we also taught you that we need to stay close to God and do the right things in our actions, in our words, and also in our attitudes. When you do your part, God will surely be around to help us. So children, just as we learned today, that we need God's power. And also, the word of God says, I can do everything through Christ who gives me strength. So let us see. Okay? Just like in this potato challenge, we can actually ask God to help us. Okay? At the count of three. 1, 2, 3.
Wow.
Wow. Something that looks impossible, but become possible because we are able to do with God's help. Now, children, God can help us, but we need to ask Him. If we don't ask God for help, how can we have help? So remember, children, even through this VBS, we want you to learn that with Jesus' power, Jesus' power will pull us through. Trust Jesus. Now, children, what is it that caused this straw not to be broken? Is because when I did this, okay, I put my finger over the end of the straw. And when I put my finger over the end of the straw, what is inside, Andrew? Yeah, very clever. That's why you're a doctor, lah. Okay? Air. When there is air, and I put my finger over it, the air is trapped. And air that is trapped and compressed inside makes it super strong as a weapon to jam even into the potato. So children, do you know God gave us the Holy Spirit? The Holy Spirit lives in you, me, and all the children out there. So when we have Jesus in us, we have power to do hard things. So children, don't give up. Remember this. Okay? See you tomorrow for our next object lesson. Thank you. Coco and Drew. Hello children. We are the Gizmo team of this year's VBS. I'm Auntie Peggy.
I'm Auntie Carol.
I'm Auntie Hui Ling.
And I'm Auntie Chu Xiao.
First one will be done by Auntie Cecile. Enjoy!
Hello children. Today we are going to do a hot air balloon hovercraft. Okay, these are the materials that you need. Okay, basically you need some colored paper. Okay, two bottle caps, CD, balloons, thumbtacks, blue scissors.
First you need colored paper. Contrasting colors if possible, and you cut this, you cut an outline of the CD on the colored paper and with the inner hole, so you get something like this. And after that you cut some segments from another colored paper and you paste the segment onto the pale one, so you get the contrasting colors. After that, you put this onto the CD, you glue it. You glue it, okay. And you get this. Next, you take a thumbtack and poke on the bottle cap. Children, if you are small, please ask your parents to assist you to do this. To make as many holes as possible so that air can go through. And you glue the bottle cap onto the CD. Your disc is ready. Okay, you try to pull towards the end, so you have some space here, and you try to fix it. Onto the cap. Children, this blown up hot air balloon represents Jesus. The CD represents the hard things in life. When you release the blown up air, it will help to move the CD around. So, children, remember, the blown up balloon represents Jesus, and it helps to move hard things in life. Let's have a look.
Thank you. Wow, children, you enjoy going around all the station? Wow, Auntie Susan did enjoy and learn something. You know what? Auntie Susan learned that, yes, God give us power. God give us power to do everything that we need to do. Only that we have to rely on God. So children, are you ready to close for the next song? Okay, if you are ready, let's start.
From then, bye. To the blessing of studying.